Hey friend, welcome to Vocal Warm-Up Series 1, Preparing to Voice. Hi, I'm Kate Glashine. I'm a voice and dialect coach, and today I'm going to take you through part 1 of a basic vocal warm-up. You can learn more about me at kateglashine.com, and if you enjoyed today's video, please like and subscribe below. Let's get started. To start your vocal warm-up, you want to find a nice neutral stance. So get your feet about hip width apart and as parallel as is comfortable for you. We're all constructed a little bit differently, and some of us might have some dance background, so a turnout feels more natural. So if your feet need to turn out a little bit, that's okay. Get them as parallel as is comfortable in your body. Next, move up to your knees. You want to have a nice soft micro bend in your knees. And so the easiest way to find this is to lock your knees and release them. Lock your knees, feel those quads tense up, and then release the muscles and let your knees just sort of fall into a nice, easy stance. Moving up to your shoulders, you're gonna roll your shoulders back a few times. Just remind them that they're not supposed to roll forward, which happens so much in our modern life of computers and desks. Just roll them back a couple times, make sure you're still breathing. And then moving up to your neck, you want to think of a nice long neck spine. And you can find this a couple of ways. You can lift gently through your ears with both hands, or you can find the hair on the back top part of your head. Lift gently through there. And either way, hopefully you'll feel a little bit of a lengthening in the back of your spine, back of your neck. And you might even feel that your tailbone drops. Often when we adjust one place, some of the other things that happen in our spine will release or adjust in other places. From this position, we're going to roll down the spine. And so I want you to imagine rolling down one vertebra at a time, and I'll talk you through it. Breathing out on a nice gentle F sound. Drop your chin to your chest. And then let the weight of your head take you down through your spine, one vertebra at a time, rolling down nice and slow until you're comfortably flopped over at the waist. Once you're flopped over, you'll have a larger bend in your knees at this point, which is completely fine. This is not a hamstring stretch. This will stretch your lower back, give you a little release there. And it's also a great position for you to be able to release your abdominal muscles fully and take in a nice deep breath. Feel your ribs expand. Perhaps feel the breath fill your whole torso. And so as you're flopped over, go ahead and give yourself a little shake from the hips and just to test if your head or arms are holding in any particular way. You don't want tension in either of those areas of your body, and so just a little shake will help you notice if your head is floppy and your arms are floppy. You might notice that you're holding your neck up because you're not used to being inverted like this. Just try to release and take in some nice, easy breaths. And just one more. And on your next out-breath, breathe out again on that gentle F sound and begin to roll back up your spine, stacking one vertebra on top of the other as you roll. Your arms and head are heavy until the very last moment before they come up. And take your time. If you run out of air as you roll up, just fill again and breathe out on that F sound. And when you're fully rolled up, if your hair is in your face, use your hand to move it away. Don't toss your neck and kind of mess with the alignment that you were just working on. And if you're a little dizzy, you can bounce your knees. That often helps. From here, we're going to stretch out our ribs. So go ahead and get into a more narrow stance so your feet can be very close together. And on your next in-breath, bring your arms up. And exhaling, lean over to one side. We'll get both, so it doesn't matter which. Make sure you don't collapse inward. Stay flat to whatever wall you're facing. Remember to breathe. And if you'd like, you can place your hand on your ribs. Think of breathing into that hand. Sometimes that encourages more expansion in the ribs. And on your next in-breath, coming back up to center and exhaling over to the other side. Keep breathing. And placing your hand on your ribs. Think of breathing into that hand. And on your next in-breath, coming back up to center and now taking a wider stance and opening up toward the sky. You can bounce a little if that feels good, but you might feel a little bit of a stretch across your shoulders and your upper chest. Take care to be in control of the weight of your head. Don't let your neck spine crunch. And from here, go ahead and give yourself a nice big hug and release your neck. And we'll stretch out the forgotten back ribs by alternately moving one shoulder forward and then the other. And again, remember to breathe. And you can release your arms and roll your head back up. So now we're gonna warm up the muscles around the larynx. And so go ahead and start rolling your shoulders back again. Just wanna get those muscles moving. Build up a little heat. Just get them going. Don't forget to breathe as you do this. And now bring them up to your ears and let them drop. And up to your ears and let them drop. And one more time and let them drop. And then let's give ourselves a little massage in what are called the sternocleidomastoid muscles, these big strap muscles on the side of your neck. Keep breathing as you do this. Just give a little rub there. And then down into the trapezius muscle. It's very commonplace to have tightness and knots. Keep breathing as you do. And then let's go over to the other side. And into your trapezius on this side as well. And then let's do a little stretch. So take your right ear to your right shoulder. And you're stretching out that left sternocleidomastoid muscle. And if you want an extra stretch, you can place a hand on top of your head. And don't forget to breathe. On your next inhale, come up through center and exhale over left ear to left shoulder. You can always place a hand on your abdomen to remind you to breathe nice and low to release down there. Extra stretch, you can have a hand on your head. And coming back up to center. And then you can interlace your fingers, look down and place your hands on the back of your head. The weight of your arms will stretch out your neck. No need to pull on your head at all. Keep your shoulders from rolling forward in this position or from slumping throughout the rest of your spine as well. You're nice and tall and lengthened, except that you're looking down to the floor. And you can release your hands and allow your head to float up. Take a nice big yawn and stretch. And maybe one more. And that's the end of part 1.